Hello, friends. It just so happens that animals make friends only with their own kind, or similar animals. Sure, there are instances when a cat got along with a puppy. However, there have also been cases of completely unusual interactions, such that they're even difficult to believe in. It's actually very entertaining to watch how these animals try to communicate with each other, and it's interesting to try and find the reason behind this relationship. So today I will tell you about the family of orangutans and their friends, otters. They didn't only meet at the zoo under very unusual circumstances, but also developed a very strong bond, and in fact, you will soon get to find out what came of it. A small family of orangutans, which included a 24-year-old male named Ujan, his partner, 15-year-old Sari, and their 4-year-old son, Barani, were rightfully considered the stars of the Paris des Azous, located 60 kilometers away from Brussels, the capital of Belgium. Every day, hundreds of visitors gathered around the enclosure of the huge monkeys. And since their genus is considered to be the most human-like, the orangutan family, just like people would have been, was very flattered by such attention. So in response to exclamations of admiration, the family didn't hesitate to show themselves and all the attention, and even flirted with the visitors, winking at them, and even hugging. Overall, these shaggy guys were very much content with their lives, until at one point, everything changed. The thing is that the global pandemic forced the administration of the zoo to close it to the visitors. Thus, in one instant, Ujan, Sari, and even little Barani lost the main joy of their life, the constant attention they were so used to. As soon as the number of visitors dropped to zero, the caretakers noticed that the monkeys had lost their appetite, and their mood was now very aggressive. In addition, the trio simply hid in the cave and refused to go out of it. Overall, it was obvious that the family was very upset. They were fading away before the caretaker's eyes. It even feels weird talking about it because no one knew how important people were to them, and especially their communication. The zookeeper named Matthew understood well that if things continued like that, it would be almost impossible to get the monkeys to return to their previous way of life, which meant only one thing: they would soon die. Something needed to be done, and fast. At first, the carters tried to keep them company on their own, but the smart primates understood what was going on, because they knew the workers well. Even so, it did help a little, but they were still sad. And when the initial attempt at lifting the orangutan family spirits failed, the zookeeper came up with a brilliant idea. The very next day, the smart man gave the order to build an artificial river, which was supposed to pass through the enclosure of the primate family. Its beginning, however, was deliberately put in the enclosure with the most mischievous animals of the zoo. Otters, that is. As soon as the canal was finished, the little rascals set out to check the cool innovation. Thus, the surprised little animals went down the river to see where it would take them. It should be mentioned that these nimble creatures certainly wouldn't let anyone around them get bored. Soon they found themselves in the monkey enclosure. No one knew exactly how the first encounter would go about, and if they would even end up as friends or not. But everyone hoped for the best, and that's exactly what happened. When the strange guests landed in the enclosure of the orangutans, the curious Barani, who had never seen anything like them before, was the first one to run out to meet them. To the delight of the zoo workers who watched this encounter, Barani seemed to be a bit worried about the fact that there were quite a few otters, and he was alone. But then he stretched out his arms towards them, and then one of the otters came closer to Barani, and they began to sniff each other. It took each of them a few minutes to get to know each other and conclude that neither of them was dangerous, after which they began to play together. "It was simply incredible," said the zoo workers. But then there was more. Seeing unidentified guests next to their son, Ujan and Sari immediately rushed to help him out. However, 5 minutes later, they already got to meet the otters, which was no less heartwarming. Instead of taking Barani back to the cave, the huge orangutans didn't just allow him to play with their guests, but even joined him, seeking to get to know the newcomers better. A few minutes later, the otters were already running up and down the huge and hairy back of Ujan and Sari. The mood of the monkeys quickly changed for the better. Jumping ahead, I'd like to say that a beautiful friendship started that day. Two completely different species of animals, with completely opposite interests, made friends. From the moment they first met, they began to spend almost all their time together. They mostly played catch-up and hide-and-seek. According to Matthew, otters hide under large tree trunks or wooden structures, and little Barani runs around the enclosure looking for them. Sometimes they come over simply to tease him. It really does look like kids playing on the playground. Older animals spend their time with adult orangutans, who even pick them up carefully with their huge paws and just let them run on their hairy backs. The photographers of the Belgian zoo can't keep up with the animals, but the pictures they do manage to take turn out to be rather funny. A bulletin board has been placed at the zoo entrance recently, and among other things there are pictures of the wise-looking Ujan surrounded by otters, who seem to be closely watching him as he was their teacher. Sari is feeding their friends from her hand, and little Barani is running around the enclosure with them. Having learned about Matthew's ingenious idea, the journalists wanted to talk to him to find out how the life of the zoo's main celebrities changed. According to the caretaker, he still continues to improve the enclosure, adding logs, trees, and even plants to the artificial river. Having dealt with the orangutan family depression, the caretaker also managed to develop their intelligence through games, puzzles, and even riddles. For the well-being of primates in captivity, two factors are of great importance: the size of the enclosure and the organization of their vital activities. This means that orangutans, with whom humans share 97% of their DNA, must be entertained, occupied, challenged, and kept busy mentally, emotionally, and physically at all times. The idea to build an artificial canal was quite accidental, but now no one doubts that it was a great one, because interacting with other species had an extremely positive effect on the orangutan family. Moreover, realizing that the decision to combine two enclosures was successful, the zookeepers decided to try out the idea with penguins and seals, kangaroos and pelicans, as well as giraffes and ostriches. And even despite the fact that quarantine measures have eased up now, and visitors can once again come to the zoo, this doesn't mean that the friendship between the orangutans and the otter is over. Ujan, Sari, and Barani are still the stars of the zoo, but now they have friends. The orangutan family even tried to swim to visit the otters, but that hasn't been possible so far. Meanwhile, the otters spend most of all their time in the orangutan enclosure. Having learned about such an unusual relationship between the two completely different kinds of animals, thousands of local residents rush to see this miracle with their own eyes, as nothing like this has ever happened before. As you can see, even completely different animals can make friends and find common ground in a crisis situation. Many of us can probably learn a thing or two from these amazing animals. Friends, how do you feel about Matthew's idea of making orangutans and otters become friends? Don't forget to let us know if you like the main characters of the video. Well, that's all for today. See you soon. Bye.